Hi, I'm Patrick, and this is the PICAXE computer I made. It runs an operating system I program, PLOS, which stands for Patrick Leser Operating System. As you can see, the battery's low. Anyway, it has a text editor where, you know, you can type, and then save it, in this case, as youtube.txt. And it saves it to an SD card, and then anyway, it also has a calculator where it can do math, like 567 divided by 5, which is 113. It also has a timer where, say, you can set it to count for 5 seconds, and then it will count down. It can do that in the background, even if other applications are running. And I'm not sure if you can hear it, but it's sounding an alarm sound now. So anyway, let's see. So now the battery's dead, so I'm going to give you an inside look. And, yeah. And now you can see inside it, this is the CPU, which is a PICAXE 28X2 microcontroller. This is the keyboard monitoring one, which is also a 28X2 microcontroller, both of which I programmed, and then this is the SD card reader. Originally, I had a cable going outside the case, so you could access the SD card from the outside, but then that broke, so now just inside it. And here's the power supply, 3 AA batteries, one of which is dead, so I'm swapping that out. And yeah, and then over here we have an Ethernet cable that's not used for Ethernet, but just to get 8 wires to up here where I have speakers, and then the display, a serial 20x4 OLED display. And let's see, battery's now good. And then anyway, these are the programming cables, and then this is the cable that goes to the keyboard. It's a PS2 connector. And now I have to put it back together. Now that I've replaced the batteries, I'll show you the SD card. Here's the file I wrote earlier. As you can see, hello and thank you for choosing this PLOS operating system computer. This model features the PICAXE 28X2 8-bit CPU, I2C 400 kilobits per second high-speed I/O, an SD card slot supporting up to 32 gigabytes, and a 20x4 character green OLED screen, a full PS2 keyboard support, and a PICAXE 28X2 I/O driver. And also, that's what I typed earlier.
The main
program for this was 1,367 lines. The keyboard program, 155 lines. The display program was 166 lines. And the work in progress program that I'm working on was that allows me to write a program on here and then run that program. Anyway, that's 435 lines. Total program length for all the programs combined is 2,123 lines of PICAXE BASIC. You might be wondering how it all works. Well, basically, this is the CPU microcontroller, PICAXE 28X2. It's programmed through here. It's normally programmed with an headphone cable, but you can see here that it has the headphone extension thing that allows you to do that. And yeah, and then, and anyway, it and the keyboard are programmed through these cables, and then the keyboard monitor communicates with it through I2C, which is a communication protocol that allows multiple devices on the same two wires to communicate with each other. And notice multiple wires of that. So then I also, this SD card reader also uses I2C to communicate with the CPU.
And then it uses a single wire with serial cable to communicate through going this way and then to the display here. And yeah. With this computer, I won first place in the Sacramento Regional Science Fair and fourth place in the California State Science
Fair.
Fair.